students, today we are going to study constant elasticity demand function. Constant elasticity demand function coming under the recent developments of demand theory. And here we are going to find the pragmatic approach to demand analysis. Earlier, the demand analysis takes into account only the consumer behavior with not taking into account the utility concepts. The consumer behavior analysis with the reality we need. That is, we are going to study the applied economic theory behind demand. The accepted law behind this is the fundamental theory of demand. Then demand functions directly based on market data, not considering the theory of utility, behavior of individual consumers alone under earlier version. So we need a change. We are going to find the real or applied economic theory under pragmatic approach. Demand is a multivariate function. Why demand is considered as a multivariate function? Because there are many variables influencing demand. So it is known as a multivariate function. The multivariate function used to find the values considering market behavior of consumers. Demand for commodities like the demand for food, demand for durables, demand for non-durables, etc. So it is considered in groups. The serious difficulties under pragmatic approach is the aggregation of demand over individuals and over commodities. That facilitates the need for using index numbers, and there are many limitations for using index numbers. So in order to overcome the difficulties of using index numbers, here we are using improved techniques of econometrics for finding demand functions. An important development under demand function is constant elasticity demand function. Most commonly used form of demand function is, it is given as Qx is equal to B0 into Px raised to B1 into P0 raised to B2 into Y3 raised to B3 into E raised to B4t. This is the commonly used form of demand function, a multivariate demand function. Qx representing quantity demand of commodity X, and Px is price of X. Po is the price of other commodities. Here Y represents consumers aggregate income, and E before T is the taste factor, error factor, etc., or trend factor. We can call this as a trend factor. E is the base for natural logarithm. Then B1, B2, B3, etc. are the elasticities. B1 is price elasticity of demand, B2 is the cross elasticity of demand, and B3 is income elasticity of demand. So from the demand function, we understood that quantity demand for X is a function of price of that commodity and its elasticity into price of other commodity and its elasticity B2 into income and its elasticity B3, then other factors. all other factors E before T, representing all other determinants of demand. Then the coefficients B1, B2, B3 are elasticities of demand. All elasticities of demand are assumed to remain constant. So we call this as constant elasticity of demand function. Let's go for the proof. Considering one elasticity, that is price elasticity here, that is B1. B1 is constant. So take the log of that equation. Qx is equal to, so log Qx is equal to log B0 plus B1 log Px plus B2 log P plus B3 log Y. B1 Px raised to B1 is right under log as B1 log Px. So likewise, the equation is changed as log Qx is equal to log B0 plus B1 log Px plus B2 log P plus B3 log Y. We are eliminating the trend factor for making it a symbol. Then one derivation of the function with respect to price, Px. So we are going to find the derivation of the function Qx with respect to Px. So the derivation, dou log Qx, derivation of the function, which is that function Qx. So dou log Qx divided by dou log Px, that is equal to the equation from the logarithmic equation. It is clear that the constant is B1. Okay, so the change of logarithm of one variable is equal to the proportionate change of the variable. It is the rule here. The change of the logarithm of a variable is equal to proportionate change of that variable. So we need to find log of log Qx. We are going to find equal or proportionate change in all other variables like BO, Px, PO and Y. Okay, so the equation is log Qx is equal to log BO plus B1 log Px plus B2 log PO plus B3 log Y. Log BO is a constant, then B1 log Px means B1 is the price elasticity of Px, price of that commodity, B2 cross elasticity, PO price of other commodity, etc. Then the change of the logarithm of a variable is equal to the proportionate change of that variable. Dou log Qx is equal to, we are going to find the logarithm, change of the logarithm of a variable, that is equal to proportionate change of that variable. So we are going to remove the log of one variable, dou log Qx. So removing the log variable from that function Qx, we will get dou Qx by Qx. Then we are going to remove the log of Px. Dou log Px is equal to dou Px by Px. So we are going to substitute this equation under the first order derivation. So removing the logarithm from that, it will be like this: dou Qx by Qx divided by dou Px by Px. This equation, you may find it like price elasticity equation. So the answer we will get as B1. B1 is the price elasticity. representing the equation dou qx by qx divided by dou px by px is equal to B1, that is price elasticity. Then elasticity, that is B1, is constant. The price elasticity, and if B1 is constant, the other elasticities, that is B2, B3, etc., will also constant. Okay, it is not considering the utility function. We are going to this constant elasticity function is not taking into account the utility function. The incorporate demand function with a no money illusion also. We are here going to incorporate the demand function with a no money illusion. What is meant by no money illusion? When the general price level increases, the equation is just like a homogeneous function with a degree zero. So the function is qx. It is just like a Cobb-Douglas production function. You may find it. Qx is equal to B0 Px raised to B1 into Po raised to B2 into Y raised to B3 into the trend factor. So divide all the price variables with the general price level, that is P, where P is the general price level. Income change in the same proportion. The change may be appear in the numerator as well as the denominator. So the change will be cancelled out. Hence, it is said that there is no money illusion working under constant elasticity function. Okay. Hope it is clear. Thank you.